Okay, let's move on. We've looked at zero matrices, we've looked at the identity matrix, and now we look at diagonal matrices. As before, we start with a linear transformation. And in this case, that linear transformation takes vectors of size 3 to vectors of size 3. And it's defined as follows. If you plug in x and you expose its components, then chi 0 is multiplied by delta 0, chi 1 is multiplied by delta 1, and chi 2 is multiplied by delta 2. As before, is this a linear transformation? What matrix represents it? In goes the first unit basis vector. Well, we know that the entries are multiplied by delta 0, delta 1, and delta 2, but these entries are equal to 0, so all we get is delta 0. In goes the second unit basis vector. Out pops the vector 0, delta 1, 0. In goes the third unit basis vector. Out pops the vector 0, 0, delta 2. These become the columns of the possible matrix. As such. So the question becomes, is the matrix vector multiply the same as applying the vector function? Well, the vector function takes chi 0, chi 1, chi 2, makes it into delta 0 times chi 0, delta 1 times chi 1, and delta 2 times chi 2. The question becomes, is that the same as this matrix vector multiply? Well, this times that is this, and we multiply with zeros for the rest. So indeed, the first components are the same. 0 times that plus delta 1 times chi 1 plus 0 times chi 2 is indeed that. And 0 times chi 0 plus 0 times chi 1 plus delta 2 times chi 2 is indeed this last component right here. So, we now have learned that this indeed is a linear transformation. You got to show it for the general case. Go and do it. Okay, so hopefully you've answered these questions, and hopefully you've come to the conclusion that the answer is yes. It turns out that we won't need an algorithm for setting a matrix to a diagonal matrix. Instead, we have some notebooks that show you how to use Python to do that for you, or NumPy. And we just go straight to the summary, which says, if you have a matrix with this special structure, where the diagonal equals some values, and the off-diagonal elements are all equal to 0, then that matrix is called a diagonal matrix.